Good morning, students. Last day we had begun a new chapter, India's landforms. And in the previous two videos, one of them I had talked about the Himalayan mountains or the northern mountains and the lowlands or the northern plains. In today's video, we are going to talk about the desert region, or particularly known as the Thar Desert. So, in this map, you see this region, which I have zoomed out for you here, situated in Rajasthan. This is the desert region of India, and this desert is known as the Thar Desert. So, let's see what this part deals with. The Thar Desert. The Thar Desert lies in northwestern India. It is a dry, sandy region. The sand gets blown around by the wind and forms hills called sand dunes. The desert gets very little rain, so it has very few plants. So you see that the desert region is a dry region. Okay, so the Thar Desert lies in the northwestern part of India, in Rajasthan. It is dry and sandy region. And what happens is, sand, due to its dry and light weight, it can be easily blown around by the wind. So, the wind picks up sand from one place and deposits in some other place. Due to this phenomena of the wind moving the sand around, small hill kind of formations are seen. In this picture, you can see, this kind of mountain is formed. A hill kind of region is seen in this picture. But it is not actually a mountain or a hill. It is deposition of sand. And such depositions are known as sand dunes. The desert gets very little rain. That is why it is dry. And there is a lot of sand around. And that is why very few plants grow there. As you already know, plants need water to survive. Due to little rain in the desert, the sand is dry and there is very little water, so very few plants grow there. Now let's talk about the life in the desert. Life in the desert is hard because there is so little water. It is difficult to grow crops, but canals have been dug to carry water to the desert so that more crops can be grown. The camel is an important animal for the people living in the desert. It is used for farm work and for transportation. The Thar Desert has a number of cities which are famous for their forts and palaces like Jaipur, Jodhpur and Udaipur. Many tourists come to see the deserts and its cities. So, what is being talked about in the life of the desert? What kind of life do the people live? Life in the desert is hard because there is so little water. Like in the mountains, you have seen that very few people live there because the surface is rough, it is not so easy to build roads. Similarly, in the desert region also, this is somewhat similar, but the main problem in the desert region is the lack of water. People need water to survive. So, due to very little water that is found in the desert, it is very difficult for people to live in the deserts. And hence, crops can also not be grown that easily. But canals have been dug to carry water to the desert, so more crops can be grown. What has been done to provide sufficient amount of water is canals. They are like streams. They are similar to rivers, but they are man-made. What the government does is, the government sanctions canals to be built from rivers to carry water to the driest areas of the desert region so that people can get water and crops can be harvested through the help of the water carried by the canals. The camel is an important animal for the people living in the desert. Camels are used to move from one place to another. They are used in farm works. Like here in the plain regions, we have cows. In the mountain region, there are horses. Similarly, in the desert regions, there are camels. And there are some famous cities. What are the famous cities? And these famous cities have beautiful forts. Forts, what are forts? Forts are like big palaces, okay, where kings used to live once ago. What are the places? Jaipur, Jodhpur, Udaipur. So these are the three famous cities that have forts and palaces. And many tourists go to visit these places. These places are famous attraction spots. So this is about the desert region. Now let's move on to the next part. This next part deals with the plateau region or the Deccan Plateau. See this brown portion, this triangular kind of brown section. This is the Deccan Plateau region. Okay, see the color divisions in the map. This color divisions is very necessary to be kept in mind. Okay, you need to remember these color divisions. When we are going to do the map ourselves, we need to follow these color combinations. So, this region is the Deccan Plateau region. So, let's see what is a plateau and what the Deccan Plateau, how it is different to the other regions. The Peninsular Plateau, the part of India lying south of the northern plains, is a plateau. It has the Bay of Bengal on its east, the Arabian Sea on its west, and the Indian Sea on its south. Most of this peninsula is covered by a plateau. So, this part talks about the peninsula, which we have discussed earlier at the very beginning, right? At the introduction part, we had seen what a peninsula is. So, here they have said how India is a peninsula with the Bay of Bengal in the east, the Arabian Sea in the west, and the Indian Ocean in the south. And most of this peninsula is covered by a plateau. The Aravalli Hills to the northwest of the Peninsular Plateau separates it from the desert. The Vindhya and the Satpura Hill ranges divide the plateau into two parts. The Central Highlands to the north and the Deccan Plateau to the south. So, first and foremost, what is a plateau? Let's see what a plateau is. A plateau is a structure that is similar to a mountain but somewhat different. A plateau is a high ground. Okay, compared to the plain regions, it is high. But it is flat at the top and sloping on the sides. So, this table kind of structure is known as a plateau. This is a mountain or a hill. Okay, it is pointed at the top. It has a peak. But a plateau region is flat at the top and not pointed. Okay, it is higher compared to the normal low-lying areas, but it has a flat top. So, this is the difference between a plateau and a mountain. So, we are talking about this kind of structure. And you see, the plateau region can be divided into two parts. Okay, so the Peninsular Plateau of India has two parts. What are they? First, one of them is the Central Highlands and the other one is the Deccan Plateau. Let's see this picture. Here you see the Vindhya and the Satpura ranges. They are mountains. Okay. First, the Aravalli ranges. They separate it from the desert, the Thar desert, which we have read previously. And the Vindhya and the Satpura ranges divide the plateau region into two parts. One is the Central Highlands and the other is the Deccan Plateau. So, these are the two parts of the Peninsular Plateau region of India. Mountain ranges run along the eastern and western borders of the Deccan Plateau. Those on the east are the Eastern Ghats and those on the west are the Western Ghats. These mountains do not have snow. Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada and Tapti are some important rivers of the Plateau region. Now you see the Plateau region, as I have explained to you, is flat on the top but sloping towards its sides, right? So, they have a slope kind of structure and these structures, these slope kind of structures, okay, they are not mountains, they are not like mountains, but they are known as the Eastern Ghats and the Western Ghats. To the east side, we have the Eastern Ghats, see? The Eastern Ghats, you see this small triangle that have been made here. These show hills or mountains. Okay, so these small triangles, these representing the Eastern Ghats on the east side, and on the west side we have the Western Ghats. And the rivers are Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada and Tapti. So these are the rivers that flow in the Plateau region. Now let's talk about the life in the Plateau region. Life in the Plateau region. The Plateau region is rocky and much of it is not good for farming. Some places have black soil which is good for growing crops, growing cotton. The Plateau is rich in natural resources like forests, coal and iron. So the region has many factories. Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Pune and Nagpur are some big cities of the Deccan Plateau. So you see, the Plateau region is not very suitable for farming. The land here is not fertile like that of the northern plains. But there is black soil. Okay, black soil is formed from lava. When lava, it dries down, it dries and then breaks into soil like particles. That soil, it is black in color. It's known as black soil. And this black soil is good for growing cotton. So you see, there is use of soil in the Deccan Plateau region also. So the crop that we get from this area is cotton. The Plateau is rich in natural resources like forest, coal and iron. So a number of factories are built here. Some of the important cities found here are Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Pune, Nagpur. Okay, these are some of the big cities that are seen in this region. So this is the end of this part. Okay, today I will stop with these two sections of the Thar Desert and the Deccan Plateau. In the next video, I'll be continuing with the two more remaining regions of Indian division. Okay, so we have total 6 physical landforms that we have seen, and up till now we have read 4. 2 remaining we will discuss in the next videos. So that's all for today. Thank you and bye bye.